Morning students, now coming to the last chapter in second year syllabus. This is one of the most important chapter in objective purpose. Molecular basis of inheritance. Molecular basis of inheritance. This chapter explains structure of nucleic acids. Means the DNA and RNA. Also explain DNA RNA differences. This chapter also explain replication and also protein synthesis including transcription and translation, and also lac opera. So, one of the most important chapter, molecular basis of inheritance. First coming to DNA. Okay, students, you know there are two types of nucleic acids in living organisms. There are two types of nucleic acids. What are nucleic acids? There are the polymers of the nucleotides and are present inside the nucleus. So there are two different kinds of nucleic acids in living organisms. Especially these nucleic acids are present inside the chromosomes, which are present inside the nucleus of living organism. And these two nucleic acids, one is deoxyribonucleic acid, simply this is abbreviated as DNA. Deoxyribonucleic acid, that is DNA. Second nucleic acid, ribonucleic acid, this is simply called RNA, ribonucleic acid. Okay, so there are two different kinds of nucleic acids inside the living organisms. One is deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA. Second one is ribonucleic acid, RNA. So actually this DNA, this is deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA, is most abundant nucleic acid. This is most abundant genetic material. This is most abundant genetic material. Very, very important. What is abundant genetic material? Which nucleic acid it serves as abundant genetic material? DNA is the most abundant genetic material. This is the genetic material in most of the organisms. DNA is the genetic material in most of the organisms. Okay? Now, but RNA, this is also acts as genetic material, but it is present only in certain. RNA is the genetic material only in certain organisms, not in most of the organisms. RNA is genetic material, is also genetic material, but it's not a abundant genetic material. It is the genetic material, it acts as genetic material only in certain organisms. This is the genetic material only in some plant viruses. It's a genetic material only in certain plant viruses. Anyhow, both nucleic acids can act as genetic material in organisms. But DNA is the most abundant genetic material, is found in most of the organisms as genetic material. But RNA is a rare genetic material. It is present only in certain organisms as genetic material, especially in plant viruses. But what is the major role of this RNA? The main role of RNA, it acts as messenger RNA. This is also called mRNA, messenger RNA. What is messenger RNA? It carries the genetic information from nucleus into the cytosol that is required for protein synthesis. mRNA, it carries the genetic information from nucleus into cytosol for protein synthesis. That is messenger RNA. At the same time, this RNA also acts as a adapter RNA means tRNA, transport RNA means this type of RNA play a very significant role in the transportation of amino acids during protein synthesis. These RNA, they carry amino acids during the time of protein synthesis. So this RNA carries the genetic information from nucleus into the cytosol, that is mRNA. And tRNA is transport RNA, is also called adapter molecule. This adapter molecule, it carries the amino acids during the time of protein synthesis. At the same time, this RNA also acts as a structural molecule, that is rRNA, ribosomal RNA. It acts as a structure, it plays a structural role in protein synthesis. So entire protein synthesis, it is evolved around the RNA. Entire protein synthesis, it is evolved around RNA. One, this RNA carries genetic information required for protein synthesis as mRNA. It carries the amino acids for protein synthesis as tRNA. It provides a structural role for protein synthesis, that is as RNA. So this RNA, it is played very significant role as messenger RNA, as adapter RNA, and structural RNA. But rarely it also acts as genetic material only in some plant viruses. So it is not abundant genetic material, but it also acts as a genetic material, but it's not abundant genetic material. So DNA is abundant genetic material. Okay. Similarly, these nucleic acids, all these nucleic acids, they are the polymers of nucleotides. These nucleic acids are the polymers of nucleotides. So these nucleotides are monomers. Monomers are units. Every nucleic acid, DNA and RNA, it is the polymer of many nucleotides. Nucleotides are the basic building units. They are the building blocks. Nucleotide is the monomer. It's a building block. It's a unit in the polymers of this nucleic acids. So these are the polymers of the nucleotides in which many nucleotides are combined, leading to the formation of polypeptides. In the formation of polymers. At the same time, this one of the branch of biotechnology, that is genomics. It is one of the branch of biology that plays a very significant role in the study of designing of human genomes. That is called, such advanced branch is called genomics. What is genomics? This is the computer based study. What is genomics? Genomics is the branch of biology that explains, that is the computer based study and designing of human genomes. Designing the computer based study and designing of human genomes. Human genomes. This is called the genomics. And this branch explains the structure and functions and various events of all these nucleic acids, means DNA and RNA. Genomics is one of the advanced branch in biology that explains the nature and the functions of this nucleic acids. So, this is computer-based study and designing of human genomes. That is called genomics. Okay, now coming to another point. Actually, this DNA, this is the most genetic material in most of the organisms. Okay, now this DNA, the length of DNA, it is uncertain. Length of DNA is uncertain. Length of DNA is not constant. Length of DNA is uncertain. But length of DNA, it is mainly based on number of nucleotides or base pairs. Nucleotides or base pairs. For example, greater the number of nucleotides in any DNA molecule, automatically greater the length of such DNA molecule. That is, for example, DNA is represented by very large number of base pairs. Automatically, such DNA length is also very long. For example, in some organisms, limited number of nucleotides are there in DNA molecule. Automatically, the length of such DNA molecule is very low. It is very short. So, length of DNA is uncertain. It's not constant and it is uncertain in organisms. And it is directly based on the length of DNA is uncertain, and it is directly based on the number of nucleotides or number of base pairs. Greater the number of nucleotides or base pairs in any DNA molecule, automatically the length of such DNA molecule is also very long. And DNA with limited number of base pairs or nucleotides, automatically the length is also limited. So, length of DNA, it is uncertain, and it is directly based on the number of nucleotides and the number of base pairs. Now coming to the point, the length of DNA in some organisms. Okay, for example, 5x174 bacteriophage. 5x174 bacteriophage virus. Here, 5386 nucleotides. This is the number of nucleotides. Only 5386 nucleotides are present in the DNA molecule of 5x174 bacteriophage. What type of DNA is present in this type of bacteriophage? This is SS DNA. SS DNA means single stranded DNA. Only one strand of nucleotides are there. Generally, DNA is double stranded in most of the organisms. Exceptionally, DNA may be single stranded, like as in a 5x174 bacteriophage. This is a single stranded DNA. Only one DNA strand is there. Such a strand is represented by 5386 nucleotides. But what is the number of base pairs present in this bacteriophage? Base pairs 5386 divided by 2. The number, it is base pairs number. This is nucleotide number. By 2, it gives base pairs number. Anyhow, the 5x174 bacteriophage represented by 5386 nucleotides. But what about the bacteriophage lambda? Bacteriophage lambda, it is represented by 48,000, 48,502 base pairs This is not nucleotide number, base pair. What is base pair number in bacteria? Lambda. Here dsDNA. dsDNA means double stranded DNA. Represented by 48,502 base pairs. Calculate the number of nucleotides of this bacteriophage. Base pairs into 2. That gives nucleotides number. Okay? And what about Escherichia coli bacterium? Escherichia coli bacterium, it is represented by 4.6 into 10 power 6 base pairs. That is the number of base pairs in E. coli. Okay, and one set of human genome means N number. N means one set of chromosomes. One set of chromosomes is represented by 3.3 into 10 power 9 base pairs. That is for the 2N, two sets of chromosomes. Two sets of chromosomes means diploid number of chromosomes means two genomes represented by into 2. That is 3, that is into 2 means 6.6 into 10 power 9 base pairs. That is the length of DNA in various organisms. Okay? Pi X174 bacteriophage 5386 nucleotides. And bacteriophage lambda 48,502 base pairs. E. coli 4.6 into 10 power 6 base pairs. One genome of human means 3.3 into 10 power 9 means two genomes means diploid set represented by 6.6 into 10 power 9 bases. This is the length of various organisms, and length of DNA is not subtile. It's not constant, but length of DNA is directly dependent on the number of nucleotides or number of base pairs. Okay, now coming to the DNA. This DNA and nucleic acids, any nucleic acid means DNA or RNA. DNA is the polymer of nucleotides. DNA is the polymer of nucleotides. There are two strands of polynucleotides. There are two strands. Every strand is the polymer of nucleotides. Several thousands of nucleotides are linked to form the strand. In such a way, two strands of polynucleotides are present in DNA molecule. Here, this nucleotide, this is the unit, building block, unit, monomers of this polymer. Every nucleotide is represented by three chemical components. One is nitrosin base. There are three chemical compounds in each and every nucleotide. It's the combination of three chemical compounds. One is nitrosin base, second one is sugar, ribose sugar means pentose sugar. Okay, pentose sugar means this is 5 carbon pentose sugar, and phosphate. How many chemical compounds are present in each and every unit or monomer of this polymer? Three chemical compounds are there. One is nitrosyl base, two sugar, pentose sugar, 5 carbon pentose sugar, and phosphate. The association of nitrosyl base, sugar, and phosphate. This is called nucleotide. And the association of nitrosyl base and sugar, this is called nucleoside. Very, very important. Nucleotide is represented by three chemical compounds. Nucleoside is represented by only two chemical compounds. how the nucleoside differs from the nucleotide. Nucleoside differs from the nucleotide in auxin subphosphate. But how the nucleotide differs from nucleoside? Nucleotide differs from nucleoside in the presence of phosphate. So, nucleotide except phosphate, also called nucleoside. Anyhow, tide is represented by three chemical compounds, side is represented by two chemical compounds. Phosphate is present in tide, phosphate is absent in a side. Similarly, these nitrogen bases, total nitrogen bases in a nucleic acids, there are five types. One is adenine, and second one is guanine, and third one cytosine, okay, and another one thymine, and another one uracil. What is the total number of nitrogen bases in nucleic acids including DNA and RNA? Nucleic acids, 5 types. Nitrogen bases in nucleic acids, 5 types. A, G, C, T, U. But what are the nitrogen bases in DNA? DNA is represented by total 4 nitrogen bases. 1, adenine, guanine, and cytosine, and thymine. Okay? And what are the nitrogen bases of R, N, A? Also, there are 4. One is adenine, guanine, cytosine, uracil. Very important. Uracil. What is the total number of types of bases present in nucleic acids? 5 types. In DNA, 4 types. In RNA, 4 types. What are the common bases in DNA and RNA? Adenine, guanine, cytosine. Adenine, guanine, cytosine. And what is the uncommon base in DNA and RNA? DNA is represented by thymine. Instead of thymine, uracil is present in RNA. Here, A and G, they are called purines. A and G are called purines. Adenine and guanine, they are called purines. They are heterocyclic compounds. They are heterocyclic compounds having two CN rings in their molecular structure. Very important. Purines. How many purines are there? Two purines are there. Adenine and guanine. Both constitute purines. And they are heterocyclic compounds having two CN rings. Two carbon nitrogen rings are present in their molecular structure. Similarly, C and T and U, they are called pyrimidines. Pyrimidines. And they are homocyclic compounds. Homocyclic compounds having one CN rings in their molecular structure. They contain only one ring in their molecular structure. So, total nitrogen bases in nucleic acids, 5 types. What is the ratio of pyrimidines and pyrimidines in nucleic acids? 2:3. And what is the ratio of purines and pyrimidines in DNA? That is A and G, purines, C and D, pyrimidines. 1:1 ratio. And that of RNA, A, G, purines, C, U, pyrimidines. Purines and pyrimidines, they exist 1:1 ratio. So, in both, very important, in both DNA and RNA, purines are common. Purines are common. What are purines? A and G. They are common. But in DNA and RNA, pyrimidines are different. Pyrimidines. DNA pyrimidines. What are DNA pyrimidines? C and T. But what are pyrimidines in RNA? RNA pyrimidines. That is C and U. What is the common thing in DNA and RNA? Cytosine is the common thing in DNA and RNA. Okay, so total nitrogen base is 5 types. In DNA 4 types, in RNA also 4 types. 4 bases are common in DNA and RNA, A, G, C. But thymine is present in DNA and thymine is replaced by uracilin RNA. A and G, they are considered as pyrimidine purines, homocyclic compounds having 2 CN rings and are common in DNA and RNA. Similarly, pyrimidines are CPU, heterocyclic homocyclic compounds having 1 CN ring. Pyrimidines in DNA and RNA are different. Pyrimidines are DNA C and T. Pyrimidines are RNA C and U. So one pyrimidine is common, but other pyrimidines are different. At the same time, the sugar present in nucleic acids, pentose sugar, and this pentose sugar in DNA, this is called deoxyribose sugar, and that of RNA, this is called ribose sugar. Very important. Sugar in DNA and RNA is different. Deoxyribose sugar present in DNA and the ribose sugar is present in RNA. But what is the common character of this two types of sugars? Both are 5 carbon sugars. Deoxyribose sugar is 5 carbon sugar, pentose sugar, and ribose sugar is also 5 carbon pentose sugar. But deoxyribose sugar found in DNA, ribose sugar present in RNA. Common point of this two types of sugars, both are pentose sugars. Now, this nitrogen base, it is linked with sugar. Nitrogen base is linked with sugar by glycosidic bond. This is a glycosidic bond. Now, this sugar is also linked with phosphate by ester bond. This is a glycosidic bond. This is a ester bond. So, nitrogen base is linked with sugar by glycosidic bond. Now, this is formed. It's formed the nucleoside. Now, nucleoside is linked with phosphate to form nucleotide. And the bond present between sugar and phosphate is ester bond. Bond present between nitrogen base and sugar is called a glycosidic bond. So, nucleotides are, they are the units, building blocks of DNA and as well as RNA.